Welcome students to session number 16. Today we are going to start with a new chapter, that is chapter number 3, motion in a straight line. Very interesting chapter this is. Now to begin the chapter, let me clear this title of the chapter, that is motion in a straight line. Motion in a straight line. Now the very first word comes to your mind by seeing the title of the chapter, that is motion. Before motion, I want to clear what is actually rest. Rest means what? The body lying on the floor, you can say in your own words. But physically, in physical technical terms, I can define as if the position of the body does not change with passage of time if the position of the body does not change with passage of time, then the body is said to be termed to be at rest. Till this clear? Now what is motion then? If the position of the body changes, here it changes and it rest does not changes, clear? Changes with passage of time, then the body is termed to be in motion. Till this clear? Hope it is clear. In straight means what? Now listen, straight line is also known as rectilinear motion. Rectilinear, only one of the coordinates out of three changes. In order to specify the location orientation, you can say the location, or you can say orientation of an object, of a body in three dimensional space, you need to figure it out. Three coordinates, x, y and z coordinates are needed. Clear? If only one coordinate out of three changes and other two coordinates remains constant, then such type of motion is called rectilinear motion, or you can say it as motion in a straight line. Till this clear? Hope till this is clear. Fine. So I can say if x changes, yz may be constant, then you can say rectilinear motion. Or if you can say y changes, xz remains constant. Yes or no? Or z changes, you can say xy remains constant. This all stands for what? One dimensional motion or rectilinear motion. Till this clear? Hope title is very well cleared. Now moving to the very first term, that is mechanics. What is mechanics? Mechanics is the branch of physics. Mechanics is a branch of physics which is the oldest form of physics, huh? Mechanics is a branch of physics. Is a branch of physics that deals with the conditions of rest or motion of the material objects around us. It is one of the oldest branch of physics. Till this clear? You can say that it deals with the conditions of rest or motion of the material objects around us. In this you will able to study the conditions of rest or motion of the material object that are presenting or that are surrounding us, and that branch of study which we can say that branch of physics is known as what? Mechanics. Till this clear? Moving to three sub branches of mechanics. There are three sub branches of mechanics, you can say. The very first branch of the mechanics, that is statics. Second is kinematics, and third is dynamics. Till this clear? The word statics itself seems that time is not essential here. Statics means what? Stationary objects. Kinematics, derived from the Greek word kinema means motion, that deals with motion of objects. Dynamics, from Greek word dynamics, known as power. In this class, let me see these branches in depth. The very first, that is statics, in detail we are going to study. It is the branch of mechanics that deals with the study of objects at rest, or you can say as in equilibrium, even when acted upon by several forces, Sir, what does this mean when acted upon by several forces? You'll be able to see that this book is lying on the floor. It does not mean that there is no force acting on this. No, there are several forces acting on this which are counterbalanced by each other in order to keep this object stationary. So you can say that when object is stationary, force may be acting on it and may be counterbalanced by the other force. I can say that this book is lying over means the force which are acting on this side is equal to the force acting on the downside. Then only this book will able to be very stationary on the floor. Till this clear? Even when they are under the action of several forces, the measurement of time is not essential in statistics. Till this clear? It is time independent. Second is kinematics. Again, we'll study over. It is the branch of mechanics that deals with the study of motion of objects without considering the cause of motion. See, this is the branch of physics that deals with the study of motion of your objects, but without considering the cause for the motion. What is the reason behind this motion is not being studied over here. Here just study of the motion is being studied. There is no extra study regarding what is the cause for this motion. This branch of physics is known as kinematics. Here measurement of time, here measurement of time is essential. Because we are dealing with motion of objects. Clear? So it is essential. The word kinematics, I have already described. The word kinematics comes from Greek word kinema, means motion. Is this clear? Moving to the next, that is third, dynamics. It is the branch of mechanics that deals with the study of motion of objects. Taking into consideration the cause of their motion. Here in kinematics, the cause for the motion was not studied. Only the study of motion of the object was taken into consideration. Here you will be able to notice that the cause for their motion is also studied in due course of studying motion. The word dynamics comes from Greek word dynamics, which means power. That I already told you. One more point we can add over here. Dynamics is concerned with Forces which cause motion, because here force is taken into account, cause is taken into account. Motion is caused by what? External force only, external agency only, you can say. So it's concerned with forces which cause motion. More you can say over here, Newton contributed a lot to dynamics. You know the famous laws of motion? Yes. By postulating his famous laws of motion. These laws of motions are being studied into the category of what? Dynamics. Till this clear? Now next is, the topic is rest and motion are relative terms. Rest and motion are relative terms. Now remember, the rest and motion, these two individual terms are termed to be relative. Relative means what? They are dependent on each other, you can say. Relative means they are connected to each other. Yes or no? Connected to each other. I can give you an example that if you are sitting in a train, your fellow passenger is sitting besides you. If you are seeing on his, you are seeing to that fellow passenger, you will be able to see that you both are stationary. Yes or no? But if the third person standing on the platform outside the train can see you that both are in motion. So you can say, what you can conclude from here, that if you, the object may be at rest with one person, with reference to one object, but may be in motion with reference to another object. Yes or no? So here you can say that, what you can say that the object may be at rest with respect to one object and at the same time it may be motioned relative to another object. Hence motion and rest are relative terms connected to each other. Till this clear? So I can write and give the example over here. A passenger sitting in a moving train is at rest. I have given the example I am quoting over here. Is at rest with respect to his fellow passenger, with respect to his fellow passenger, because you both are moving in the same direction with the same speed, that's why you feel what? Stationary. With respect to his fellow passenger, but he is in motion, but he is in motion with respect to the objects outside the train, with respect to the objects outside the train, outside the train, thus an object may be at rest, may be at rest with respect to one object, and at the same time it may be in motion, relative to another object. Hence, rest and motion are relative terms. Till this clear? Hope it is cleared. Moving ahead to the next topic. Absolute rest and motion are unknown. Absolute rest and motion are unknown. See, here we have discussed that rest and motion are relative terms. What is absolute rest? Absolute rest means complete rest. If you are saying it is rest with respect to something which is at absolute rest, then you will be able to describe absolute rest. And you should have a perfect example of motion, a standard for comparing. That is, if it is in motion, then you can say that it's absolute motion. Clear? In order to know whether the position of the change is with time or not, a point absolutely fixed in space has to be chosen as reference point. Yes. In order to determine whether the object is moving or whether the object is at rest, you need some reference point. Yes or no? And that reference points need to be into the space, existing into the space. If it is not existing in the space, then how can you compare that whether the object is at rest or whether the object is in motion? Yes or no? That standard point should be defined into the space. But here we know that there is no such absolutely fixed point in the space, so that you cannot say about absolute rest also. And there is no perfect, if you cannot define absolute rest, you cannot define absolute motion also. Yes or no? Let us see into detail. In order to know whether the position of an object changes with time or not, see, suppose I can give you example, a boy standing over here and another boy is over here. If you want to say that this boy is moving, means its position should change with respect to this. This should be staying over here only, and this should move over here. So you should have some reference point or not. Yes or no? With this reference point, you will be able to explain that this boy is moving or is at rest. Yes or no? Moving or at rest. So similarly, in order to know whether the position of an object changes with time or not, a point absolutely fixed in space has to be chosen as reference point. Clear? Now if you want to define absolute, I can give you example. If you take any of the object in the space that is to be stationary, is it possible? Every planet revolves around the sun. In fact, Earth is revolving around the sun. In fact, entire solar system is revolving around various Milky Ways. Yes or no? Various Milky Ways are revolving around another Milky Ways, clusters of Milky Ways. Yes or no? So you can say that in universe, nothing is at rest. All are moving. Yes or no? So you can put a quote of an example over here that, but no such points, but You can say, but no such point is known in the universe. You cannot find a point in a universe which you can choose as standard. Yes or no? Reference. The earth revolves around the sun. The earth revolves around the sun. The entire solar system. The entire solar system travels through our own galaxy. Travels through our own galaxy. Yes or no? The Milky Way and clusters. Milky Way and clusters of galaxies move with respect to one another. Yes or no? They are also moving with respect to one another. Other clusters. So no object in the universe is in the state of absolute rest, you can say. There is nothing in this galaxy or in this universe which is stationary. So you cannot say anything which is at absolute rest, and you cannot choose that as a reference point for comparing another body with it. Yes or no? So no object in the universe is in a state of absolute rest, as no object in the universe is at absolute rest. Is at absolute rest. So the absolute motion. So the absolute motion cannot be realized. Cannot be realized. Only relative rest. Relative rest and relative motion. Relative rest and relative motion can be realized. Clear or not? You cannot say anything about absolute, but you can say about relative rest and relative motion. Relative means you can compare it with one object. May vary. Means I have given you the example of a passenger sitting in the train. The fellow passenger and both the passengers will see that they are stationary. The third person, at the same time, the third person seeing from the outside of the train will move. He will able to see that these two are moving with some certain speed. So you may be at rest with something. At the same time, you may be at motion with some other thing. Hope it is cleared. Fine. Last, I want to define the definition of rest. What is rest? An object is said to be at rest. An object is said to be at rest if it does not changes its position with respect to its surrounding. With passage of time. Yes or no? With passage of time. Example, I can give you a book lying on floor. A book lying on table. More precisely, I can say. Next term I want to define is motion. An object is said to be in motion. Said to be in motion if it changes its position with respect to its surrounding with passage of time. With passage of time, example I can give you over here is a train moving on rail. Moving on rails. Till this clear? Hope we'll continue for further topics in the next session. Clear? Thank you. Have a nice day.